Today's topic on hand is facial oils, and we're specifically going to be talking about the difference between facial oils and body oils, and how you decide what ingredients are going to go into a facial oil, and exactly what the benefits of a facial oil is, and why you would even use one. Hey, what's up, and welcome back to my series of Formulating for Beginners. If you are new here, I'm in the middle of a series targeted to beginners who are new to formulating. So if you're new, go check out the playlist I've linked down below and binge watch all those videos before watching this one, because this video will make a lot more sense if you do it that way. So what is a facial oil? By the way, I'll be reading from my blog. I have a blog that goes right along with this video over on my Patreon. And if this video sounds confusing, go check out the blog, because the blog is much more thoroughly written. Anyways, let's get into it. So what is a facial oil? Facial oils are anhydrous products. They are made up of only oil-soluble ingredients. Facial oils can be used for many reasons. Facial oils can help moisturize the skin. They can actually help balance the skin oil production to get rid of excess oils. And you can even use them on top of your moisturizers to help lock in those active ingredients and protect your skin. You may also want to use a facial oil to help reduce wrinkles, to minimize pores, soothe inflammation, or even fight acne. Some people even like to use facial oils as a primer before they put on their makeup. There are many reasons why you may want to use a facial oil. It really just depends on what your skin type is and what you're looking for. So what's found in a facial oil? Obviously, oils are found in facial oils, but they can have much more than that. So basically anything that's oil soluble can go in a facial oil. For example, carrier oils, vitamin E oil, silicones and silicone alternatives, emollient esters, and oil soluble extracts. Another thing you might want to avoid when making a facial oil are hard oils like coconut oil and palm oil. So what's the difference between a body oil and a facial oil? So body oils typically contain less expensive ingredients compared to facial oils. The skin on our face is much more sensitive. It's exposed to sun more often, and typically we have more target issues on our face as compared to our body. And you'll normally notice that most of us are trying to fix issues on our faces much more than on our body. But of course, people do experience skin issues on their body as well. But for the mass majority, people are going to be spending more money on products for the face rather than for the body. Another difference between the two is facial oils are typically formulated for a target skin type, maybe oily, dry, acne prone, mature, and body oils tend to focus on more like it's this scent, it's that scent, it relaxes you. That's typically what I see with body oils. They don't normally say things like for acne prone skin, because not too many people have acne on their body. Of course, we get it on our like back or chest, stuff like that. But oftentimes we'll bring facial products down to our chest. So for things like on our legs and stuff, we're not normally dealing with acne and stuff like that. So this is the difference between body oils and facial oils. Again, of course you can use expensive ingredients in your body oils if you wish, but I'm just talking about the mass majority between the difference. Facial oils typically have more expensive ingredients as compared to body oils. How do you begin formulating a facial oil? First, you need to figure out what skin type you're formulating for and what would you like in your facial oil. So of course it will be a moisturizing product, because oils are obviously moisturizing to the skin, but what else do you want to do? Do you want to reduce wrinkles, fight acne, reduce pore size, balance oil production? Figure out what you want your facial oil to do for your skin. And I'll give you examples of certain ingredients that can help with certain skin issues. So anti-aging. If you have mature skin, you might want to use some baobab oil, camellia seed oil, timanu oil, I think that's how it's pronounced, carrot seed oil, argan oil, chai seed oil, jojoba oil, blackberry seed oil, and evening primrose oil. If you want to balance oil production, you could use squalane, jojoba oil, macadamia oil, and neem oil. To fight acne, you could use safflower oil, neem oil, hemp seed oil, grape seed oil, black cumin seed oil. To soothe skin, you can use broccoli seed oil, almond oil, macadamia oil, hazelnut oil, argan oil, chai seed oil. And to help brighten your skin, you can use cucumber seed oil or carrot seed oil. Just keep in mind that this is just like a general guideline. Just because the oil is said to help with a certain issue, it doesn't mean it necessarily will. I think it's very important to do your own experimenting with oils. Maybe buy like a handful of different types of oils and try them out on your face specifically so you can see how they react on your face and see which ones you like. Another thing I want to mention is that oils contain linoleic and oleic acids. Some contain more linoleic and some contain more oleic, and some can be pretty balanced. Oily skin likes linoleic acid and dry aging skin likes oleic acid. It's a good idea to find the perfect balance between the two for your skin. And of course, different oils contain different minerals and vitamins. So if you're looking for some vitamin A, find an oil that has a high potency of vitamin A. So how much of each ingredient do you use? How do you know what percentage to use them at? So I went into extreme detail over this topic in my last two videos, but I wanna talk about it a little briefly here as well. You wanna follow the recommended, suggested, or typical usage rate that's provided by suppliers. You can use most oils at 100%, but you might not wanna use every oil at 100%. Neem oil, for example, stinks. You wanna dilute that baby down. Sea buckthorn oil and carrot seed oil are super orange and can stain your skin, so you wanna dilute that. Evening primrose oil is very, very heavy oil, so you don't wanna use that on its own, dilute that down. And those are just some examples as to why you might not wanna use an oil at 100%, especially for other expensive oils like rosehip seed oil. You might not want to use that because it's so expensive, but since our faces are a smaller surface area, you could use rosehip oil at 100% on your face, even though it's expensive. So why would you use silicones or silicone alternatives? I mentioned before that you may find silicones and silicone alternatives in facial oils. The reason you may want to use these types of ingredients is because they create a more dry, non-greasy feeling to the product. Oils can be really greasy and sticky and just kind of uncomfortable on the skin, and no matter how much blending you do, you may never be able to find the perfect balance of oils to where it doesn't feel like sticky and uncomfortable. And this is when silicones and silicones alternatives will come in and make your body oils feel a lot more luxurious. So I've never personally used like dimethicone or cyclomethicone in body oils, but I have used silicone alternatives. The three silicone alternatives I really like, actually they're the only three I've ever used, is Coco Caprylate, Naturcil, and Neo Essence Hemisqualane. Love them, they feel great. They're all EcoCert, they're all considered natural, green friendly. And these three ingredients can really make a facial oil feel much more pleasant. So why use emollient esters? I talked a little bit about emollient esters a couple videos ago. Specifically, I focused on IPM, but now I really wanna focus on caprylic/capric triglyceride. I used this in my last video when I made my advanced body oil. And let's talk about this. So capric triglyceride is an emollient ester, and it's commonly referred to as fractionated coconut oil. It's made from combining oil and glycerin, and it's gone through an extraction process called esterification. Like I said, I used this as my primary oil in my advanced body oil in the last video. Some say that fractionated coconut oil and capric triglyceride are the same thing, and other people say that they're two different things. I've done research and I've came to the conclusion that they are two different things from my research, but anytime I try to find fractionated coconut oil from a supplier, if you go to the INCI, it'll say caprylic/capric triglyceride. So I'm so confused. Does fractionated coconut oil even exist? Like, I don't know. Please let me know down in the comments. And if you have found a fractionated coconut oil that isn't capric triglyceride, give me a link to it because I want to check it out, because I really want to figure out this mystery because I'm so confused by it, because I always thought they were the same thing, but I just recently found out that they're not. So please, please enlighten me, please. I really wanna know. But anyways, the point I'm trying to get at is capric triglyceride is a great ingredient to use in facial oils because it's not heavy at all. And then the last two other emollient esters that I'm familiar with is IPM, which I already talked about that before. And then there's C12-15 alkali benzoate. Never used it, don't really know anything about it other than the information provided by the supplier that I've read. So let me know what you think of that ingredient down below, because I've never used it. So why would you use extracts in facial oils? You really can only use oil-soluble extracts and facial oils. You could do a water and oil emulsion with water-soluble extracts, but that's a little too advanced. I don't really want to get into that. You know, this is for beginners, and we're sticking with products that don't need preservatives. I wouldn't recommend using a oil-soluble extract in a facial oil without a preservative. Just to be safe, let me know what you think about it. Is it safe? Like, have you microbial test a oil-soluble ingredient that has an extract in it without a preservative? Let me know, because I've never done it, so I can't really say for sure or not if it's safe. So let me know what your thoughts are on that. But just to be safe, I want to advise to you guys to make sure you use a preservative if it has an extract in it, because extracts go bad pretty easily. But even though we won't be using oil-soluble extracts in our facial oil, I wanted to bring this up because I knew I'd get comments about it, because I get comments all the time asking me if they can use oil-soluble extracts in anhydrous products. And the truth is I don't really know 100% if it's okay or not. I just say use a preservative just in case, because I'd rather you guys be safe. I don't want to give you guys information that might end up harming you. So this is just why I say it. Please let me know if you have insight on this. But the reason why you might want to use an extract in a facial oil is for the lovely benefits. There are so many amazing extracts, and they're all derived from awesome botanicals or even beer. I've literally seen beer extracts, so they don't even have to be from a plant. I've seen sake extract as well. There are so many amazing, like, cool extracts out there. I also seen champagne extracts, so they don't really need to be from botanicals and stuff. But yeah, the reason why you might want to use an extract in your facial serum is for the lovely benefits that extracts have that you can't always find in oils. So what about other ingredients? Are there any other ingredients you can use in facial oils? There are, but I only know of one. So let me know if you have any suggestions of oil-soluble ingredients that can go in facial oils down in the comments. But I only really can think of one at this moment of me recording and making this video. But that ingredient is coenzyme Q10 pure powder. So this is a bright orange powder that's oil soluble. Coenzyme Q10 is a coenzyme vital to production of energy within cells. It is also a very powerful antioxidant and free radical scavenger. The issue with this ingredient is its solubility is really low. So to incorporate it into an oil, you need to slowly heat your oil to 120 degrees, around 49 degrees Celsius, and stir the powder into the oil until it dissolves. But due to the very low solubility of this ingredient, it can re-solidify, you know, turn back into a powder and settle to the bottom of the facial serum. And in order to fix this issue, you can just like reheat your facial serum. That's kind of a pain. Like, who wants to do that before they add a serum on their face every day? So this is why I don't highly recommend coenzyme Q10 in a facial serum, because it's just kind of a pain. But there is an alternative to it. You could get coenzyme Q10-Q-Max. This is from Lotion Crafter, and it is coenzyme Q10 powder that has been pre-dissolved into a ester and vitamin E, I believe. That way it can stay in its liquid state and not re-solidify into a powder. So you can use the coenzyme Q10-Q-Max in a facial serum and not worry about it turning back into a powder. So that's an awesome ingredient to add into facial serums. And that's basically everything you need to know before you start formulating your facial oil. So have fun doing research on different oils and seeing which ones are good for your target skin problems that you wanna solve. Make a little list of all the different oils that you wanna add into your facial oil. And in the next video, we will actually be formulating 2 different facial oils. And with all that said, let's move on to the Patreon shoutouts.
At Stardust Bath and Body over on Instagram, Nature's Farm Girl at naturesfarmgirl.com, Kennedy's Essentials at kennedysessentials.net, Let's Blend at letsblend.bigcartel.com, Creative with Love at creativewithlove.me, Wallflower Wildflower at wallflowerwildflower.com, Heartfelt Beauty here on YouTube, at sugared_pineapple over on Instagram, KAJ Bath and Body over on Etsy, Blue Mint Soaps at bluemintsoaps.com, Saytera here on YouTube, at Salt Air Label over on Instagram, Lanice Beauty at lanicebeauty.com, Ardrew Naturals at ardrewnaturals.com, sharkcitynaturals.com, sharkcitycbd.com, Ohana Lay at ohanalay.com, and at Danny Botanicals over on Instagram. And one more thing, if you guys didn't know, I do sell products myself over on Etsy. I'll have my Etsy shop linked down below, along with all of my lovely patrons.
So I do hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you guys would like to see in this Formulating for Beginners series, and I'll talk to you guys next time. Later. I'm stuck in the motions. I've been consumed by the wrath of time, like I'm broke. I'm shattered in this life. It's still the path that I've chosen. Because I've had a vision, now I'm on a mission to find myself.